If this is your first time visiting the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and don't forget to give me a thumbs up if you like the content on the channel. Welcome to Nerd Guy News, NGN, where all nerds collide. From the legendary actor Wesley Snipes to the rising star of Mahershala Ali, Blade is going to be set very differently in the MCU, or should I say retro? Let's talk about it. Now, this is just my opinion, but I honestly believe this is going to be the best MCU movie to be produced yet. Just because of the simple fact that, you know, Wesley Snipes took on this role back in the 90s and it was absolutely legendary. It was iconic. And now that Mahershala Ali is taking on this iconic role, I honestly believe that he's going to knock it out of the park playing Blade. Now, Marvel and Kevin Feige, they are planning on making this Blade movie to be probably one of the best Blade movies to be produced. And the way they're thinking about doing this, rumors and speculation say that they're trying to go back to the 70s, that the movie would be taking place in the 70s. So if you're a big Marvel fan like I am, you guys know that Blade, the very first comic book, took place in the 70s, and he was like a retro style type of Blade. He had like the green jacket and the stakes with the green boots and the blue boots. Like, he was real retro. He had like the afro and everything. And, you know, I think this is a perfect thing here for Blade, because you gotta think about it, he's half human, half vampire, and he has those vampire abilities. So, you know, he doesn't really age, and he's also known as the Daywalker. So, you know, there's many different routes that Marvel can go with this. And I think if they cast Mahershala Ali as Blade and put him in the 70s, this would be the perfect groundwork for him that he's been in the MCU for a while. It's just no one has really seen him. He's been off doing his own thing, you know. And it would be also a great concept of if you cast him in the 70s, kind of like how they did with Captain Marvel, you know, how they took it back a couple years back, like a generation, a decade or so back, where the 70s is a very interesting time. You know, it's right when computers and technology was really starting to kick off, you know, certain cell phones and stuff were really coming out. So maybe we get to see like a different version of Blade then. And then, you know, through the ages, we'll see him progress, you know, and then he'll become the modern Blade that we all know and love, that the Wesley Snipes version of him, you know, we get like the more tactical version of Blade versus the, you know, just wearing the retro green jacket with the fro and all that type of stuff. We'll get an actual like cool Black Ops version of Blade. So if this is the route that Marvel is going, I think it's going to be a great groundwork for him. I think the movie is going to be great. Who's going to be the villain for this movie? I have no idea yet. That's something that I'm still looking into. Hopefully they won't do Dracula right off the bat. I'm sure Dracula would be like the shadowy figure, one of the most, I guess, ominous figure that's in the background, that's just lurking in the background, because eventually it's going to lead up to Dracula. You know, he's going to have to fight Dracula eventually. So maybe we might get that somewhere later on in Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness. Maybe somewhere we'll see some other villains that are lurking within the MCU. But that's a whole nother topic. But I honestly believe Blade set in the 70s is going to be a great way to start off this version of Blade. And this will also extend Mahershala Ali's contract as Blade if he decides to do this, because you can set it in the 70s, the 80s, and 90s, and then you can, you know, take it up a notch. That's like 6 or 7 movies you can get out of Blade. So hopefully they'll just milk the heck out of this, because Blade has been off the big screen for such a long time, and I really think Marvel is going to make bank if they do this, especially if they do it right. And I honestly believe they're going to do it right. I mean, I haven't really seen any Marvel movie that really flopped, you know. I mean, they all make great money. They all do great in box office and in theaters, you know. I just honestly believe this is going to be a great movie, and the fact that they got Mahershala Ali to play this awesome cool character, guys, I cannot wait to see how Mahershala Ali looks in this movie. I mean, there have been pictures and mock-ups of him, you know, concept pictures and stuff like that of him dressing up as Blade. There's even been a picture of him sporting a brand new haircut that was very similar to Wesley Snipes' version of Blade, or the Blade that's in the comic book. So this is going to be great. This is going to be awesome. I can't wait to see where this goes. The MCU is very bright, and I honestly think Blade is going to be a great movie. So hopefully in the 70s, we'll get this awesome, cool Blade, and then eventually we'll see the Blade that we all pretty much know and love in the MCU, fighting along Doctor Strange and all the other awesome Avengers. And maybe they even might start like a Midnight Suns thing, because apparently I think they're bringing over some of the rights of the television shows over to the MCU. So hopefully we'll get to see like Ghost Rider and Blade and Moon Knight, all of them come together and have a Midnight Suns movie. I think that'd be pretty cool to have a small or short MCU arc of the Midnight Suns. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this brief little video on Blade information in the MCU, please make sure you smash that subscribe button, hit that notifications bell. Also, like this video. It helps out in a big, big way. I really do appreciate it. And if you want to, you can go over to my other channel as well, Moto 6 Sanity, where I have other different content on there as well, if you like motorcycles and stuff like that. But anyway, guys, that's it for this, and I will catch y'all guys next time on the next episode. Stay nerdy, stay super, stay nerdy. Stay on NGN. Just watch my channel. I got more content coming soon, guys. Peace out.